Students of BIMTECH PGDM Retail Management Class of 2017 presents you with their video of industrial visit to Meerut, the sports capital of India. Reaching our first destination, Stagg International, at around 10 in the morning, we were welcomed by factory manager Mr. Maghavendra Brahma, who was very helpful in showing us the premises. He also briefed us about the precautions that should be taken inside the manufacturing plant, which were to maintain distance from the work area so that the students don't go near the hazardous material and avoid any potential injuries. Along with the classmates and factory officials, we entered to the main manufacturing area. The workers and the officials were very helpful in the Stagg Industries. We got an opportunity to talk to the quality control manager and operations manager, who gave us detailed insight about the manufacturing plant. During the conversation, we got to know that Stagg supplies their products to around 190 countries world over and have a wide range of 450 to 550 differentiated category products. All the logistics are partnered by DHL Courier Delivery Services, be it importing from India or from Europe. Inside the factory, the first thing we noticed was next to the dispatch area was the packaging unit, as well as the imported unprocessed table tennis boards in a very confined space, thereby utilizing the limited space. This led to some issues in sending the finished product to the dispatch area.
In the coming shots, you can see that Stagg imprints its logo on various finished products that are to be retailed under its own name and exported to various countries. These include TT bats, balls, squash bats and covers, gym equipments, basketball board and other items.
Now looking into the manufacturing process of the Stagg. The first step includes the cutting and the welding of all the raw materials. After this process, the ionized painting of the pipes begins. Then the product goes into the furnaces for heating at 3000 degrees Celsius of temperature, and finally the end product comes out. The table tennis board which are manufactured are basically of two types. The one for the indoor is primed and then spray painted as shown in the video. Finally, after the paint dries in the furnaces, the boundary and the markings are made on the table with the white stripes. Inside the manufacturing plant, products like the wheel bases are assembled and painted manually. Also, the indigenous TT bats are manufactured and packed manually in the facility. The video here shows the packaging of wheel bases that are to be sent along with the table to the retailer. This packaging area is near the dispatch unit and was observed to be handled as we entered the manufacturing facility.
Above the factory, they have a warehouse which is mid-sized, and the goods are stocked in bulk in their respective packaging cartons. They also warehouse products from companies like Adidas, Nike and Puma. After the wonderful experience at Stagg Industry, we visited a Government of India venture by the name of MSME, that is Micro Scale and Medium Enterprises, which were concerned in the manufacturing of cricket equipments. The entire inventory of MSME is catered to the local market of the entire country. The MSME also helps in setting up of small level businesses, as well as generates employment for those who are in need of it. It also helps those people who need capital for starting up of small scale ventures with loans.
The pictures here depict the leather house where they primarily manufacture cricket balls. Cricket bat manufacturing unit can also be seen in a picture. Then we headed towards the wholesale market of sports goods, where how does a retailer deal with inventory in bulk was analyzed. Mostly the inventory that was stocked in the shop was catering to the local markets only. According to a local retailer, bulk purchases were done in this market to be supplied to various parts of the country. Thus, by dealing in bulk, the retailers could offer certain discounts. Another unique thing which we came across was that most of the retailers in that market were in the business for more than 10 years. Thus, they had developed excellent customer handling skills.